Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into an exciting AI showdown, where we'll be testing DeepSeek's latest version 3.1 against GPT-5 and Gemini 2.5 Pro. We'll be putting these models through their paces with everything from logical reasoning challenges to coding tasks, and we'll see which AI comes out on top. So grab your coffee, hit that like button, and let's jump straight into our testing lab. All right, so here's our setup. We've got DeepSeek 3.1, and notice they've rebranded their thinking process from Think to Deep Think. Pretty cool. For GPT-5, I'm accessing it through Perplexity, and of course we have Gemini 2.5 Pro ready to go. First test, logical reasoning. All right, so here's our first question. This is a logical-based question, so let's give this question to both models. I'm sending it to DeepSeek first, and wow, look at that. DeepSeek is already starting to think a lot, as usual. And here, GPT-5 already gave the answer. Like, super fast. And DeepSeek is still thinking? Man, this guy really takes his time. You know what? Till we get the answer from DeepSeek, let's ask the same question to Gemini also. Let's see. Gemini is also super fast, and you can see it gave the same answer as GPT. Meanwhile, our DeepSeek model is still thinking. Let me just let DeepSeek do his thinking, and in the meantime, let me tell you what has actually changed in DeepSeek 3.1. So here are the benchmarks, and as you can see from the previous model, it's not a huge change, but yeah, it has improved a lot. Earlier, for the SWE bench, it scored 44, and now 3.1 scores 66. Which shows good improvement in coding. Besides coding, it has also improved in multilingual capabilities too. Not huge by numbers, but it's a good improvement. Unlike GPT-5, which came as a disaster for a lot of people. And on this slide, you can see all the top model benchmarks for the Artificial Intelligence Analysis Index. In this, GPT is at the top, then Grok 4, and if we look at DeepSeek, then it comes behind Gemini as well as the GPT-OSS120B model. Which I completely disagree with. I have actually tested the GPT-OSS model completely, and will be releasing that video soon. Anyway, let's check, is DeepSeek still thinking, or is he done with his thinking? Okay, so here's the answer from DeepSeek, and the answer he gave is option A, which is the correct answer. As you can see in this question, only option A is correct, not both A and D. So yeah, DeepSeek takes time, but he gives the correct answer. Both GPT-5 and Gemini 2.5 Pro both failed here. 1 point to DeepSeek. Second test, more logic. Here's the second question. Again, logical reasoning. Let's send this question to all models. Now aside, GPT is crazy fast here, as always. Oh my god, this time DeepSeek took 453 seconds, which is crazy. That's like, what, over 7 minutes? Wow. Okay, let's check both answers and see which is correct. DeepSeek gave output option A is correct, and GPT-5 is also correct here. The answer should be 1 apple equals 1.2 bananas. And I deliberately gave wrong options to check whether they would change their answer in order to fit with the options given. You know, to confuse them. But both DeepSeek as well as GPT-5 gave accurate answers, so both models get 1 point each. Coding test 1, Mario game. Okay, now let's test it with some coding. Here we gave a prompt to create a state-of-the-art Mario game using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So let's send this prompt to both models as well as to Gemini. Okay, so both models started writing their code, and oh, Gemini finishes first. Let's click to play and it looks very basic. Not really state of the art. So I click space and arrow to move. I think there's something wrong. Okay, wait, I got it. I have to click space and then use arrow, not one by one. It will move only when Mario's flying. Okay, very basic game. It comes with sound effects, which is good, but visuals are very basic. Let's check GPT-5. Let me copy this code and paste it. Here's the game, click on start, and guys, I think it's not working. The start button is not working at all. What the heck, GPT? Let's go to DeepSeek. Oh, DeepSeek is finished. Let me check the code, and this looks much better to me. Better than Gemini and much better than GPT-5. So here we have score and coins, and we have enemies down there. This looks good to me. It doesn't come with sound, so I think let's give the point to DeepSeek. It's visually much better. Point to DeepSeek. Coding test 2. Freelance dashboard. Okay, another coding question. So here's the prompt. Generate a modern interactive website using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript for freelance that has a dashboard for finished projects, pending projects, and potential clients in one dashboard. Make the animation smoother and look modern. Okay, so let's send this to DeepSeek. Here's the Gemini output, which I will say is looking clean, minimal, simple, and has animations too. The drag and drop feature is working perfectly and it's smooth. Good job, Gemini. Let's check GPT-5. Here's the output. This looks similar to Gemini in theme, but it has more features and more functions than Gemini. Okay, so let's add some projects. Oops, no. None of these buttons are working. GPT again messed up. Come on, man. Let's check DeepSeek. Wow, I think DeepSeek clearly wins here. It has all the parameters like projects done, how much pending, and total earnings, and it keeps updating if we move stuff around. Like, let's drag and drop and check whether it's updating or not. And as you can see, it's updating perfectly with smooth animations. So DeepSeek again wins here. Point to DeepSeek. Final coding test. Bird animation. Okay, last coding question. Here's the prompt. Create a web page showing a bird using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Let's send this to all these models. Here's the Gemini 2.5 Pro result, which is good. You can see the bird's eye is moving as I move the mouse. So that's a good touch-up, and the bird looks good. Now let's check GPT-5, and here we go again. Why GPT? Why? He added all the parameter settings, yet nothing shows here. I don't know if it's a problem with Perplexity or GPT itself. Anyway, we'll give another option to GPT-5 and let's see. Okay, so here it is. After some trial and error, this is what GPT-5 has generated. It's not perfect. As you can see, the feathers are inverted, but overall it looks good. And GPT also added some other features like changing the tone and animate or not, and save as PNG. So he tried to think more creatively, but failed at first. Anyway, let's check DeepSeek. And here's the output of DeepSeek. What can I say to this? Haha, I think DeepSeek did some operation to this bird. Nowhere does it look like a healthy, perfect bird. Only the front portion can be looked at as a bird, but DeepSeek fails here. But DeepSeek also gives options like changing the wing flap speed and bird size. So, point given to Gemini and GPT-5. Final thoughts and conclusion. So here's the conclusion, guys. DeepSeek overall performs good. I can say it performs better than GPT and Gemini in some cases. And looking at the cost of DeepSeek, DeepSeek is very cost-effective and the best model out there for budget users. But here's the problem with DeepSeek. It takes a lot of time to think. It has improved from the earlier version, but it still thinks a lot. What GPT or Gemini can do in a few seconds, DeepSeek will take several minutes. So this is just a negative point, I would say. Okay, so that's it for today, guys. If you want full testing of DeepSeek with other models, do comment down below which models you want me to compare it with. And also, I'm soon releasing GPTOSS model testing, so click that subscribe button for updates. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.